Hi, I'm Joe Feeks, editor of Pig Health Today, and with me is Dr. Jake Schwartz. He is a veterinarian at the Swine Vet Center in St. Peter, Minnesota. Jake, thank you again for joining us.
Absolutely. Glad to be here.
Now, your clinic is based in St. Peter, but it's not limited to Minnesota, is it?
Yep. Based in St. Peter, Minnesota, we would service clients primarily in the Midwest, Minnesota, Iowa, Nebraska, Kansas. But would do some work in the Carolinas and the Panhandle from time to time as well.
So now farms in Nebraska have been commanding a lot of your attention.
Yeah.
Specifically with Seneca Valley virus. Tell me about that.
Yeah, so in the state of Nebraska, from June 7th to the end of June of 2017, they had over 120 foreign animal disease investigations that came from a single packing plant. And in these foreign animal disease investigations, pigs tested negative, obviously, for a foreign animal disease, but positive for Seneca Valley virus. And so one of my clients in Nebraska ended up having pigs test positive at the packing plant for Seneca Valley virus. So that's how I kind of got into this.
So you've been looking at Seneca Valley virus in both the sow herd and the finishers, but let's talk about your work in the finishers, because if it ended up in the packing plant, I'm assuming that's where it was in this particular herd.
Yeah, so that's kind of an area that is a little bit gray yet, in that sometimes we send pigs from a site to a packing plant, and at the site there's been no reports of lesions or anything wrong with the animals, but they show up at the packing plant and they have lesions. In other instances, it's been fairly clear that we'll have pigs sent to market. They get to market, they have lesions. We'll go back to the site, and the pigs will have lesions. And so sometimes it feels like the site itself is becoming infected. Or has been infected, and in other instances, you're uncertain. One, were they ever really infected at the site, or two, were they infected and the lesions heal relatively fast in a period of a week or two, mm-hmm. And so was it there at one point in time, and did we just miss it? And so it's, I think, as far as understanding the virus. And understanding the epidemiology of the virus, I think we need to do a better job of trying to understand how much drag back are we getting of Seneca Valley to these finishing sites when we have pigs test positive at the plant.
Well, let's talk about that a little bit. So from what I'm hearing, the producer was not even aware that there was a Seneca Valley problem until it was discovered in the plant?
Yes, that's correct. And to add to that, of the 120 some cases in the state of Nebraska last June, there were zero reports of lesions at these sites. These sites came from five different states: Kansas, Minnesota, Iowa, Nebraska, and South Dakota, from all five states to this single packing plant in Nebraska. And no, during this time frame, there was no reports of lesions at any of the finishing sites. So, mm-hmm. Either that is really the case, and the virus didn't get dragged back to the site, or it was there and we didn't notice it or we missed it.
And specifically, what does Seneca Valley virus do to the finishing herd?
Yeah, that's a good question. So. The main thing it does is why there's so much concern around the virus is not so much of an economic impact to the herd, where Seneca Valley virus is why it's such a big deal is it does produce lesions. It causes vesicular lesions of the snout and the feet and coronary bands, which are indistinguishable from foreign animal diseases. Mm-hmm. And so that's the main thing. You'll have the blisters of the snout, and sometimes you'll get acute onset of lameness, which is associated with the vesicles or lesions of the feet.
So Jake, tell me, how does Seneca Valley virus get into a herd in the first place? What's the most likely route of transmission?
That's a really Good question, and that's something that we still are working to try and understand better today. I would say, as far as risk factors for a grow finish herd or for a finishing site to contract the virus at the farm, one of the biggest thing is marketing, the marketing event. We learned with PED that it's not uncommon to have trailers go to the packing plant negative for PED and the trailer leaves positive, right? And so a lot of the Seneca Valley virus breaks have been associated with marketing events. And so the feeling is that that we're taking pigs or trailer, truck and trailer to the packing plant, it's getting infected, and we're dragging it back to the site with our trailer. So that would be the big risk factor in finishing. There's been discussion, there's some research out there about that mice in the barn can potentially harbor the virus and flies as vectors and stuff like that. So that's not the only avenue that's being looked at, but certainly today it feels like marketing is a big risk factor.
Are there certain types of farms that might be more susceptible to Seneca Valley than others? Are there certain types of facilities or management practices that might keep the door a little wider open for infection?
I think, a big deal or risk factor would be, quite honestly, how we manage our trailers. There's a lot of variability in our industry with marketing trailers, how they're managed. Are they washed between every load? Are they bio-dried between every load? Or maybe it's not uncommon to not wash and to not do some of those things. And I think that, we talk a lot about foreign animal disease, and Seneca Valley virus certainly brings up that discussion because of the vesicles and lesions that it causes. But I think, as we talk about getting ready or being prepared for foreign animal disease, as we talk about vaccine banks and all these things that are really important, I think a part of that discussion needs to be, as an industry, how do we manage our trailers, marketing trailers, in a manner that would slow down or reduce the risk of contaminating in the event that we did get a foreign animal disease into this country.
Have you noticed any patterns in terms of the presence of Seneca Valley virus in the finishing herd and the presence of other viruses or bacteria in that herd?
I have not. That's a good question. I can't say that I've drawn any type of parallels between having other diseases and also having Seneca Valley virus. Not to say that an association doesn't exist, I haven't looked into that.
Okay. Basically, what is the best defense against this disease in the finishing herd right now?
The best defense against the disease would be to thoroughly wash, disinfect, and bio-dry your trailer. Bio-dry, there's what it is, essentially get the trailer to a surface temperature of 150, 160 degrees Fahrenheit. And we know that works quite well for PERS and PED. I don't know if a lot of that work has been validated for Seneca Valley viruses as far as the thermo-assisted drying process being enough to kill Seneca Valley virus. As far as common disinfectants, if thermo-assisted drying isn't an option that you have in your system right now, bleach is one of the better disinfectants when compared to other common disinfectants, specifically for Seneca Valley. So time, temperature, and disinfection.
Now, we've talked a lot about the finishing herd, but obviously this is an issue in the sow herd as well.
Yep.
What are some patterns or trends that you've seen in the sow herd? Are there certain, again, certain types of management practices that might favor the introduction of Seneca Valley to the sow herd?
Similar to the finishing herd, I think it's all about biosecurity and I know I've sold cull sows, or my client has sold cull sows, and they'll leave the sow farm that I'm working with. They'll leave their negative, and we don't have any Seneca on the plant, but they'll go to the buying station, and they'll end up testing positive at the buying station or at a cull market of some sort. And so to me, a big risk factor for the sow farm is the cull buying stations and those trailers that come onto the farm.
What can you do about that?
As far as mitigating the risk for trailers, it's very similar discussion as far as thermo-assisted drying and clean and disinfecting the trailer.
And lastly, if it's a problem in the sow herd, is it quite likely then it'll be a problem in the finishing herd?
That's a really interesting question. My experience has been that your sow herd will break. Let's say a sow herd breaks. For a period of time, they're going to wean pigs that you will detect Seneca Valley virus in. In my experience, we've weaned positive pigs that we were able to detect the virus in. But they didn't develop the lesions associated with Seneca Valley virus. So it's kind of tricky. We're at a state in our industry where I don't think we really understand a lot about the pathogenesis or the epidemiology of the virus at this point, quite honestly, to answer some of those questions that you have.
Does it remind you of any other particular virus that you're battling on a regular basis or have battled in the past?
Reminds me, I remember it wasn't that long ago I was in vet school, and you learn about foot and mouth disease and all these vesicular diseases, and you don't think that you're ever going to see it in your career. And so the scary part is the striking, the lesions that it produces is not distinguishable from foreign animal diseases.